of my help, all of my help comes from you, my Savior. All of my help, all of my help, all of my help comes from you. It comes from you.
All of my help comes from you.
I look to the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Greetings, my name is Mia Gutridge, the First Lady of St. Luke A.M.E. Zion Church, also known as the House of Healing, where our pastor is the Reverend Dwight L. Gutridge. I am here today to invite you to our virtual worship experience. I ask that you will sit back, relax, clap your hands, stomp your feet, and allow the presence of the Lord to penetrate inside of you. Thank you and be blessed.
Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and enter his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name, for the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations.
The Old Testament scripture, Deuteronomy 6, verses 4 through 9, NIV. Deuteronomy 6, 4 through 9. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today are to be on your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road and when you lie down and when you get up. Tie them as symbols on your hands and bind them on your forehead. Write them down on the door frames of your houses and your gates.
Our New Testament scripture reading is 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 3 through 6. And I'll be reading from the New King James Version, 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 3 through 6. I thank God, whom I serve with a pure conscience, as my forefathers did, as without ceasing I remember you in my prayers at night and day, greatly desiring to see you, being mindful of your tears, that I may be filled with joy when I call to remembrance the genuine faith that is in you, which dwelt first in your grandmother Lois and your mother Eunice, and I am persuaded is in you also. Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God which is in you through the laying on of my hands. Amen.
Every day, send your anointing. Eternal Father, as once again we come before your throne with praise and thanksgiving. Lord God, we come to you in the name of Jesus. We exalt you, we bless you, we give you glory and honor, for truly you alone are worthy of it. And Lord God, we want to say thank you because you've been so good to us. Father, we thank you for just allowing us to see this day, for brand new mercies you've given us. We say thank you. You didn't have to, but you did. And we thank you, Lord God, for loving on us unconditionally. Father, as we come to you, we do ask that you forgive us for our sins. Father, that we've committed by thought, word, and deed throughout this week, Lord. And we're thankful for another opportunity where we can repent and come before your throne, Lord God. You've given us another opportunity to make it right, to do better. We say thank you. Now, Father, as we come to you at this time, we ask, Lord God, that you will have mercy upon we, your people. We ask, Lord God, that you will allow your spirit to dwell, to reign within this worship experience. We want you to have your way. Father, we ask that you will be with the manservant that is bringing your word. Anoint him afresh, that the words that are uttered out of his vessel are ordained by you and you alone. Father, we need you in times like this. Father God, and help us, Lord God, to put our focus on you. Help us, Lord God, to not get weary in well-doing, but continue to trust you, to look to the hills from which cometh our help. Father, we ask that you will be with the leadership, from the leadership of our nation to the leadership of our churches. Father, it's time to put our focus completely on you. So help us, Lord. We need more of you, Father. And recognizing that we are still on assignment. We are still here with purpose. And Lord God, you have still given us a mandate. So Lord, we ask that you will fill us up with more of you. Cleanse us from all unrighteousness so that we can see you and hear you. Father, help us. For we need you, and we thank you for this day and for this time. In Jesus' name, thank God and amen, amen, and amen.
Show me your face, fill up this space, through this space. My world needs you right now. My world needs you right now.
Hey, St. Luke. Hey, family and friends. It's Pastor G coming to you from St. Luke A.M.E. Zion Church, the House of Healing here in Grand Rapids. Let me first start by wishing our mothers a happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day to my mother, happy Mother's Day to my wife, and happy Mother's Day to my daughter. Thank God for everything mothers do 365 days of the year. We appreciate and love you all for your nurturing spirit and taking care of us when we couldn't take care of ourselves. And so God bless you, mothers, and God ever keep you. Will you join me as we now dig into the Word of God? Our scripture lesson for today is coming from 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 3 through 6. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 3 through 6. It reads something like this. I thank God, whom I serve as my ancestors did. With a clear conscience, as night and day, I constantly remember you in my prayers. Recalling your tears, I long to see you so that I may be filled with joy. Here it is, y'all. I am reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother Lois and in your mother Eunice. And I am persuaded now lives in you also. For this reason, I remind you to fan into the flame the gift of God, which is in you through the laying on of my hands. I want to talk about, for a couple of moments today, I get it from my mama. I get it from my mama. Let's have a word of prayer. Speak now, Lord, for your servant heareth. Speak, God, and encourage your people with this word on today. Now may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be found acceptable in your sight. For God, you are my strength, you are my redeemer, and you are the rock that I stand on to proclaim this your word. Do it again, God. Allow treasure to come from trash. Do it again, God. Allow a blessing to come from one who has been broken. Now, God, center me so that I might preach your word with power and authority. We don't want to preach a word that sounds good. We want to preach a word through the Holy Spirit that will do some good. It's in the name of your Son and our Savior Jesus we pray. Amen. I get it from my mama. Family, by way of introduction, many of us can attest today on this day that is designated to celebrate our mothers, that some of the greatest lessons that we learned in our lives were learned at the hands of our mothers. Will you holler back at your screen and say, you're right about it, preacher. If you had a mother anything like mine, everything was a lesson to be learned. Everything was a lesson to be learned. If you failed at something, that was a lesson in learning to fail and to try again without quitting. If you succeeded at something, that was a lesson on winning, but also staying humble in your success. If we're honest, and if we look back at our childhoods, we will remember that it is often our mothers who were our first teachers. Before daycare could keep you, before preschool could encourage you, before elementary school could mold you, before high school could challenge you, and before college could train you, it was our mothers who gave us our first lessons. And the truth is, be told, she continued to do so as we matriculated through life. Hear me. Whether the lessons are good lessons or bad lessons, we got them from our mamas. Whether the lessons were simple lessons or complex lessons, we got them from our mamas. Whether the lessons hurt us or helped us, they were lessons that we received from our mamas. No, I am not discounting fathers, because there are lessons that we get from fathers as well. But this is Mother's Day, isn't it? But we also know that early on as children, we spent a good portion of our time with Mama. May I suggest to you today, my family and friends, that there are some things about each of us that if we were to search out the root of why we do what we do and who we have become, I submit that each would come to the conclusion that we got it from our mamas. Notice I didn't say everything about us. I said there are some things about us that we clearly got from our mamas. There are even certain sayings and habits that we got from Mama. Here it is, one of mine is, I cannot stand a thief and a liar. My mama would always say that to us when we were growing up, and now I find myself saying it. I have even noticed that my daughter has gotten some things from her mama, the way that she looks at people when she's a little upset with them. She'll stare them down like her mama. My daughter can even tune someone out who is talking to her and completely focus on something else just like her mama. Whether we know it or not, our mothers influence and impact our lives in ways that sometimes we do not realize. May I cut across the field to the scripture. In both scripture lessons that you heard read on today, thank you, Reverend Keith, and thank you, Reverend Robinson, we see the impact and influence of parental guidance, specifically the impact that a mother can have on her children. Watch this, y'all. In our Old Testament scripture, Deuteronomy chapter 6, that was shared, parents are told that they have a responsibility to train up their children in the way that they should go in their relationship that they have with God. Moses tells them this in Deuteronomy. He says, these commandments that I have given to you today are to be on your hearts. Impress them upon your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and even when you get up. May I suggest to you that because of the defined gender roles of antiquity and the patriarchal standards that were set in place, it was often the woman or the mother who was expected to give her children life lessons, while the man or the father acted as the hunter and the gatherer. It was even the mother who shared with her children the testimony of who God was and where he had brought his people from. The mother would quiz her children about their history. The mother would quiz her children about what God had did for them in past. It was the mother who would insist that her children learn the commandments given to them by God. The mother would teach her children to pray good prayers of good Jewish children, like the one we hear in Psalms 31 when we commend our spirits into the Lord's hand. What they came to know about God, they got it from their mama. Watch this. Even in our New Testament, we are given evidence of a mother and a grandmother who was instrumental in the faith development of a young pastor by the name of Timothy, who was Paul's son in the ministry. Notice that Paul talks about something that is in Timothy that is deposited in him by his mama. May I also suggest to you who are listening that Paul is suggesting that long before he met Timothy, long before he started teaching Timothy, that the women in his life made a spiritual deposit into their male child. Despite what bad theology says, a woman can teach her son the ways of God. I want to encourage you, family, because this is Mother's Day, with this fact, that many of us came to know God because of our mamas. Come on, talk back to me. Somebody ought to thank God for mothers who poured into their children lessons about God. Somebody ought to thank God for praying mothers who did not give up on us when we were going in the wrong direction. May I make it personal if you don't mind? Thank God for my mama who took her hands off of me when I didn't want anybody's hands on me. She stopped fussing at me. She simply gave me to God in prayer. Did you catch what I said? She gave me, she turned me over to God in prayer, said, God, you do with what you want to do with him. And I wonder if I have a witness watching who will comment or holler back at your monitor that when somebody decides to give you to God in prayer, your life will never be the same and there's nothing that you can do about it. Woo, good God Almighty. I am here today because I had a praying mama who made up her mind that I would live and not die. Thank you, mama. And I want you to know today that many of us have been blessed beyond measure by God because our mothers stood in the gap for us in prayer. Our mothers put something in us that helped us to fall in love with God. May I suggest to you today that this is a message being lifted up in both the Old and the New Testament scriptures. The text is tailored to teach us that there are some essential things that those in the text got from their mama. Would you like to hear them? Here they are. First, they got their foundation in God. They got their foundation in God from their mamas. Check the text, y'all. In the Old Testament, I already read it. The seventh verse of Deuteronomy says this. These commandments I give you today are to be on your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road and when you lie down and when you get up. Here it is, family. The writer of this text tells parents that they are to lay the foundation with their children by talking about God, teaching about God, and tarrying with God for a little while. In fact, the mother was, if in fact the mother was responsible for teaching her children, she is told what to teach them. Teach them about the goodness of God and how he has kept his people. She is told where to teach them. As you sit at home and when you walk around on the roads, she is even told when to teach them. When you lie down at night and when you get up first thing in the morning, you ought to be talking about our God. Watch this. They were to be intentional about laying a godly foundation for their children to build upon. Thank God. May I suggest to you, family, that when you build your foundation on God and not man, that your foundation will not ever crumble. And when the weight of the world is upon it, it will not crumble if God is its foundation. When you build on God, strong winds might blow, but you will not be moved. When you build your foundation on God, the billows may roll, but we will not be shaken, nor will we be stirred. Because of what our mamas put in us, we do not build on temporal ground. We build on things eternal. The songwriter said, build your hopes on things eternal. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. I put my trust and my hope in God because that is my foundation. But next, the text blesses me because it tells us that Our mamas helped to form our faith in God, to form our faith in God. Paul tells Timothy in our New Testament text that the faith that I see in you did not start with you. Oh, no. I've seen it living in your grandmother Lois and also living in your mother Eunice. Notice that Paul said that he could see this faith living in Timothy's grandmama and Timothy's mama, Priest Gutridge. That means that their faith was active and on full display. When everybody else may have doubted about whether God was going to keep his people who were under persecution in the first century church, Lois and Eunice walked in confidence that God would keep them. When trials and tribulations came to God's people, Lois and Eunice didn't tell God about their trials and tribulations. They told their trials and tribulations about their God. Oh, that's good to me. Lois and Eunice may have been those two sisters in the church that knew how to send up some timber in prayer and call on the name of Jesus like they were losing their minds. Family, each of us need people in our families that embody faith. In my family, can I share? It is my mother. Oh, yes, it is. My mother has been through so much with her health in her life, but yet she continues to press her way forward in faith. My mother continues to believe by faith that God is her healer. Her praise has never changed. Her worship of God has remained strong. Her faith has helped her to hold on until her change comes. Thank you, Mama, for being a model of faith for all of your children and those who are around you. But watch this. Paul says that faith that they operated in is now in Timothy. I need you to know, you cannot pass faith down to someone. No, you can't. But you can be such an example of faith that those who see you will want to have what you have. This model of faith is first seen in Timothy's grandmother and then Timothy's mama. And Paul says that I'm convinced that it is now in you as well, Timothy. Paul says to Timothy that the faith that I see in you, I'm convinced that you got it from your mama. This faith that Paul sees living in Timothy is a faith that has allowed this young pastor to lead people into a deeper relationship with God. This faith that Paul sees in Timothy allows Timothy to preach boldly about the Savior that picked him up when he was down. This faith that Paul sees in Timothy will allow him to stand strong even when the storms of life are raging in his life. Somebody shout faith. Paul says, I see faith in you, Timothy. And this is the type of faith each of us should have. It's the type of faith that Vanessa Bell Armstrong says, I have the faith to see the invisible, expect the incredible, receive the impossible. Oh, faith that can conquer anything. Faith that uproots my problem. Faith to know that God can solve it. Faith to vision my freedom. I have the faith that can conquer anything. Faith to reach the unreachable. Faith to fight the unbeatable. Faith to remove the unmovable. Faith to stand the invincible. Faith that can conquer anything. May I suggest to you, family, that all of us have to have faith in our God to see us through even these moments that we're in. Finally, beloved, may I suggest that the text is tailored to teach us that Paul also saw in Timothy fire for God. Fire for God. That's good to me, y'all. Paul tells Timothy that I remind you, watch the text, y'all, to fan into the flame the gift of God, which is in you. Watch this, family. I want to say it in King James. He says to stir up the gift. But in the NIV, he calls it a flame or a fire that is in you. Hear me. If Timothy was around his mama and grandmama, and they had some gifts and fire on the inside of them, it would not be hard to believe that Timothy would get some of that fire for God on him and in him. Preach, black man. That is why Paul says you must fan the flame that is in you. You do know, family, you cannot fan something or fan into something that is not there. Paul recognized that Timothy had something on the inside of him. He had a fire or zeal for God. It was probably the same fire and zeal that he witnessed in his mama and grandmama. And I got to tell you this, as I help you help me. You cannot live off of mama's fire. We should desire to have our own fire for God. What am I saying? We cannot live off of our parents' or grandparents' relationship with God. We must have one for ourselves. We must come to know Jesus in the pardoning of our own sins. Timothy had his own fire that may have started with his grandmother and mother, but now Timothy is on fire for himself. May I share with you, family, an observation I have made. My wife, Mia, is a worshiper. Oh, God. She goes hard for the Lord. She sings hard. She directs hard. She praises hard. And now when I see my daughter Ebony in worship, she goes as hard as her mama does. She watched her mama fan the flame. And I submit by way of the Holy Ghost that now she fans the flame that is in her just like her mama. I gotta go now, family. May the Lord bless you real good. But before I go, somebody ought to say that I get it from my mama. I get my boldness from my mama. I get my tenacity from my mama. I get my audacity from my mama. I get my grace from my mama. I get my sensitivity from my mama. I get my love from my mama. I get my foundation from my mama. I get my faith from my mama. I get my fire from God from my mama. Is there anybody here who will holler back at me that I get it from my mama? I'm so glad that it was the faith of our mothers, living yet in cradle song and bedtime prayers, in nursery's love and fireside love. The presence still pervades the air. Faith of our mothers, lavish faith, the fount of childhood's trust and grace. Oh, may thy consecration prove the wellspring of a nobler race. Faith of our mothers, guiding faith, for youth longing, doubtful doubt, how blurred our vision, blind our way, the providential care without. Faith of our mothers, Christian faith, in truth beyond our man-made creeds, still serve the home and save the church and breathe thy spirit through our deeds. Faith of our mothers, Christian faith, we will be true thee till death. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the blessed Holy Ghost, have a great Mother's Day. Amen. You've heard the word of God, and whenever the word of God is preached, there ought to be a response to God's word. And so I want to invite you into relationship with Jesus if you do not know Jesus in the pardoning of your sins. If you don't know Jesus, I'm going to pray the prayer of repentance. You ought to pray it with me. And if you pray that prayer and you receive Jesus in your heart, then you are saved. Also, if there is one who would like to become a part of St. Luke A.M.E. Zion Church, the House of Healing, where we believe that you'll receive a word of hope. If you're weary, you'll be helped. And if you're wounded, you'll be healed. If you want to be a part of a loving congregation of people who love the Lord and His word, we invite you to join us virtually. Will you pray with me? Father, we thank you and bless you for this day. Thank you for your word. Thank you for mothers who have sown into our lives. Now, God, I pray that someone prays this prayer with me. Father, I am a sinner, but I confess it with my mouth and believe it in my heart that Jesus is the Son of God. Please, God, come into my life. Come into my heart. Change me, renew me, restore me, and reconcile me with you, O God. Send your sweet spirit to be a part of my life. I receive you now, God, in the name of Jesus, amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, if there are those who are out there watching who want to be a part of our church family virtually, please, God, bring them to us. Allow this word to penetrate lives. Allow this word to change lives. Allow this word to be not just a word that sounded good, but a word that did some good in someone's life. Bless our mothers. Bless our grandmothers. Bless those who are mother-like, surrogate mothers, godmothers, aunties who have served as mothers. Bless them, God, as only you can. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Thank God, if you prayed that prayer where you want to be saved, you can send us a private inbox message through our St. Luke A.M.E. Zion Facebook page. Amen. If you want to join the church virtually, you can do the same thing. Let me thank God for the members of the church who continue to give greatly, who have been great stewards of their time, their talent, and their treasure. Thank you for what you continue to do. Let me remind you of the ways that you are able to give to St. Luke if you are a member of the church, of this church. If you are a member of another church, we want you to be a blessing to the church that you are a member of. But if you are not a member of any church and we're blessing you, please feel free to sow a seed. Three ways. You can go to Givelify and look up St. Luke A.M.E. Zion Grand Rapids, St. Luke A.M.E. Zion Grand Rapids, Michigan. The second way is through Cash App. Our Cash App name is $ St. Luke A.M.E.Z. $ St. Luke A.M.E.Z. And finally, you can mail whatever contributions you would like to mail to our church. The address is 101 Delaware Street Southeast, Grand Rapids, Michigan, 49507. Again, that's 101 Delaware Street Southeast, Grand Rapids, Michigan, 49507. We thank God for you allowing us to come into your homes another week. We pray that God continues to smile on you and keep you safe from harm, hurt, or danger, both seen and unseen. We will see you next week if God says the same.
Happy Mother's Day. I'm Sister Sauda Smith, one of the associate ministers at St. Luke A.M.E. Zion Church, the House of Healing in Grand Rapids, Michigan. I just want to thank you all for joining us for another virtual worship experience, and I hope the service has blessed you as it has blessed me. Feel free to like us on Facebook and subscribe to us on YouTube so you'll be the first to know about new content as it arrives. Whether you're a mother, an adopted mother, a godmother, an aunt, a great-grandmother, whoever you may be, a mother figure, I want to say Happy Mother's Day from us, St. Luke, to you out there virtually. Happy Mother's Day, everyone. See you next time.
You see, I'm still here. Let me adjust my cry. Everything's gonna be all right.